So I've got the new MacBook Air M2 and it is great, but Apple failed on one thing with it, or failed to tell us one thing about it. But to keep this simple, I'm first of all going to answer one big question that I always get asked with brand new Macs. And then after that, I'm going to show you the unboxing what I did for the MacBook Air M2. So what is that question, you may ask? Well, that question is, can you game on the brand new MacBook Air M2? And the answer to that is, yes you can, especially if you use Nvidia's GeForce Now, who is actually sponsoring today's video. Nvidia's GeForce Now lets you play high frames per second games on the likes of a MacBook with an M1 chipset, and also at 1440p and 120 frames per second via the cloud. GeForce Now gives amazing quality and features like ray tracing, Nvidia DLSS from the powerful GeForce RTX servers that even offer an RTX 3080 gameplay experience. You can stream your own AAA title games over the internet like Cyberpunk 2077 right to your Mac or even your iPhone or iPad using Safari. Even if you have a PC, laptop or Chromebook, you can still stream your games to these devices as well. And you never have to install games that can take up hundreds of gigabytes of space on your new devices. You just simply have to own them. If you are thinking of getting yourself a brand new Mac, I would really encourage you to try out GeForce Now, especially that you can try it out for totally free by going to this link right here to download the app, and I'll also put that link in my description for the video. And with that out of the way guys, let's now do the unboxing for the brand new MacBook. So this time around, as you can see on the box, it's a side angle of the new MacBook Air, and it's quite a standard kind of Apple looking box. It's a white box as you normally get, and like I said, you just normally get a picture of the product on the front, and yeah, it's really, really thin, you can see here on the picture. So let's just turn it around here. You've got all the other bits of information and stuff like that on it, and at the top we've got a tab to open up the seal. So let's pull this open and get that peeled off. Let's get all this plastic on and let's see how eco-friendly this box boxes, as it were, to the environment. Apple like to do this quite a lot. First of all, we do have some plastic though, that isn't that eco, but you know, you can't win all the time. So let's put it to one side and let's pull this open. This is the best moment. Ready? And voila! There we have it. There is the MacBook Air inside the box. I'm gonna pull this. This is paper. So yeah, we can see there we've got like a circle there. I guess that's where the Apple logo is underneath there. Let's turn it over and yeah, let's give it a pull. Oh, I love that feeling where you can just pull it away. That is absolutely fantastic. Let's just pull out the MacBook. Wow, look at that. Let me just show you guys. Look at the colors there. Oh, you can see my fingers marks on it already. I can't believe it. Look at that. That's where I just grabbed it from. So I can see what people are saying. It is a bit of a finger magnet, but just look at this gorgeous color. I'm just trying to rub that away, but let's admire the color for a second. It is gorgeous on there, and I love the design. It's really nice. We'll put that to one side for the moment. Let's just see what else is inside this box. Put the paper one side as well. So we have here the MagSafe free charger, what is color coordinated to the MacBook. I like that this time around. That's really, really cool. I do like it. It's blackish there, and it's kind of got that midnight color on the actual main cable, but it's got a white end on the USB-C. We have sort of some instructions and bits and pieces in here. Let me just see, let's see if we can get out of here. I'm just trying to pull it here. So, oh, there we go. We've got the sort of MacBook Air instructions inside it there. So just telling you how to sort of operate it, where the ports are. What else we've got here? We've got some warranty bits and pieces information and safety. You know what, you know, all of that kind of stuff. You wanna have fun reading that. And then here's the big one, the stickers. If I can get them out. I can't actually get them out. I think you guys are gonna have to give me a second. Let me see if I can get them out.
6.5 hours later.
There we go. Finally got them out at last. It's taken me ages to get these out. So let me just show you here. There we go. They're in midnight color, just like the MacBook Air. It looks really, really nice. I actually like it. The colors are different again, just like we got with the iMac. And you can see here, they're actually bigger than the main logo actually on the MacBook. So if you wanted to stick it over the top, you can do that if you really, really wanted to. But that's up to you. But yeah, I do like it, the color of them. I like that the stickers are different. But the MacBook is absolutely amazing, and it definitely is gorgeous. So I'm just gonna put it to one side. Let's have a look what we got here. We've got a UK plug, because I'm from the UK. We have this 3-pin one here. And then because this is the base model, I got the standard kind of 30 watt charger. Let me just see if I can open this. It's in paper again. Let me just peel this off. It's kind of just a standard kind of MacBook charger, or some of the iPads have this charger now, maybe a little bit smaller. And depending on what MacBook you get, you either get a large one or a bigger one. There we go, got it out, and there we have it. There is the brand new charger and everything then with this. So I'm just gonna put that down. I just wanna show you guys just quickly, there's nothing else inside the box. That is everything you get with the unboxing for the MacBook Air. So let's do a bit more of an overview of this brand new MacBook Air M2. And the first thing you must have noticed is we have a brand new color, as you can see here. This is the brand new midnight color. We also have a brand new twilight color as well. But the first thing I did notice, what a lot of other YouTubers and a lot of other reviewers have said out there, it is a bit of a finger magnet and it does leave a lot of marks. But comparing this brand new MacBook Air M2 to the older MacBook Air M1, first of all, you can see a thickness difference here, that the MacBook Air is basically thinner at one end, but thicker at the other, because you've got that more of that wedge design. But the brand new MacBook Air M2 has that kind of brand new design, what's really similar to the likes of, say, the 14-inch MacBook Pro, but just a lot more thinner. The weight is basically almost identical to the MacBook Air M1, but I have been told it's about a pound lighter, but I can't really tell the difference in my hands. But for ports-wise, we do have a bit of a change here. This year, we actually have the MagSafe 3 charger on the brand new MacBook Air M2, whereas the M1 Air didn't have this. You did have to use USB-C to charge it, but you can still use USB-C charging for the brand new MacBook Air as well. The look is also a bit more different as well, especially like if I open it up here, we've also got this notch inside the screen, whereas the older M1 Air didn't actually have this. The display itself though on the brand new M2 MacBook Air is really, really crisp, but there isn't any Pro Motion inside it. I've also been testing out this brand new MacBook Air, and I've opened up a few tabs and I've also opened up pages as well, and this MacBook Air is absolutely fine in handling tasks like this. So yeah, we're onto something a bit special here. Now, I do say special, but I mean special depending on who the user is. And I want to show you the one thing that lets down the MacBook Air. And that, very simply, is just usage. Now, as I've just shown you, if you jumped onto this MacBook Air for, say, 30 or 40 minutes a day, opened a few Safari tabs, checked your email, wrote the odd letter, say, in Pages, then you'd have no problems. But what I would say is, do not buy this MacBook Air if you're planning to use high-end tasks on this. And what I mean by this, if you're planning on buying this MacBook Air base model to use it for, say, Final Cut Pro, photo editing, having, say, 10 tabs open all at the same time, and maybe Photoshop open as well with it, this MacBook Air is just simply not going to cut it. Even if it costs $1,200, you do need a more powerful MacBook. We've got to remember that the MacBook Air is completely fanless, and if you start to use sort of high-end tasks on this MacBook, it will start to struggle. I've opened exactly what I said. I've opened up Final Cut Pro, Photoshop, and 10 tabs, and look at the heat compared here. I've got the 14-inch MacBook Pro, and then next to that, I've got the MacBook Air, and you can see the temperature is a little bit higher here on this M1 model, and then compare it to the M2 MacBook Air. It's about 44 degrees, and that's absolutely crazy. It's much more hotter inside this machine. And the two reasons behind this? Well, one is because it's a fanless design, and what goes along with that is Apple have designed this MacBook Air to basically be completely fanless, because they're not intending the user to buy it to run kind of say things like Final Cut Pro, Photoshop really regularly every single day and for long periods of time. It's just simply not designed for that. This is what the M1 Pro, M1 Max, and even what the M1 Ultra is for. Another factor is the M2 chipset is bigger than the M1 footprint, with a faster clock speed and an extra GPU core on the base model M2 MacBook Air compared to the M1 MacBook Air, meaning it will get hotter quickly, especially that it's sitting on the same 5-nanometer die as well. This MacBook Air will get hot if you try to use it for professional tasks, and for that you're better off saying getting the base model 14-inch MacBook Pro with dual fans inside. But from my point of view, this is where I believe Apple has failed us. We now have a bigger M2 chipset, what's giving out even more heat, and yet it's still fanless. And then on top of that as well, as you might have seen some other reviews here on YouTube, they've only put in one NAND SSD, what basically makes the actual storage a bit more slower and could make the M2 struggle a little bit more and cause even more heat. With more heat, this basically means that the M2 chipset has to slow down, and this is called throttling, what basically means you can't utilize all the speed what's inside this actual chip. Apple are giving us a shiny new design MacBook Air that everyone will pick over, say, the chunkier 14-inch MacBook Pros, and why wouldn't you? At the end of the day, it's a MacBook on the box, isn't it? It looks nice, it's new, and it's one of the cheapest out there. But yeah, do anything beyond basic tasks on this MacBook Air and it will start to get hot and it will start to throttle and your MacBook Air will start to slow down quite quickly. So my initial conclusion for just trying out this MacBook Air for a little while, it is gorgeous, it is brilliant, it does look absolutely stunning and amazing. But the thing is, if you use this MacBook Air beyond doing basic tasks on it, and I really do mean basic tasks, do not install any pro apps on it, otherwise it will start to get hot and it will start to throttle. And with that, what I would say is you're better off saving up your money to get yourself, say, a 14-inch MacBook Pro, M1 Pro, that base model, and there are a lot of sales out there right now, and you can get one for really, really good money right now. Just check out things like Amazon and lots of other websites out there, because there's some really good prices on that. And I would really encourage to buy that instead if you're definitely going to be using pro apps. And on that note, guys, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time, guys, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Take care now. Bye-bye.